Good morning, everybody, and welcome to morning prayer on Thursday. Gosh, can't even think what the date is. 29th of October, and here at St Mark's. I'm hoping you can see the beautiful west window there. So, this morning's morning prayer reading set for today. If you are following, then the psalm is Psalm 143, set today. And our reading continues in 2 Kings, and it is chapter 23, verse 36, to chapter 24, verse 17. So 23, 36 to 24, 17. And it's one of those ones you can have fun with the name, so I'm pleased I'm not reading that one this morning. But I will be reading from our New Testament, and the reading set for today is 1 Timothy 4. So the chapter of 1 Timothy 4, and I'll be reading that one shortly. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. And the Thursday Canticle. I have given you as a light to the nations, and I have called you in righteousness. Thus says God, who created the heavens, who fashioned the earth and all that dwells in it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord, I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the captives from the dungeon, from the prison, those who sit in the darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. I have given you as a light to the nations, and I have called you in righteousness. And so our New Testament reading this morning, 1 Timothy chapter 4. Now the Spirit expressly says that in later times some will renounce the faith by paying attention to deceitful spirits and teaching of demons through the hypocrisy of liars whose consciences are seared with the hot iron. They forbid marriage and demand abstinence from foods which God created to be received with thanksgiving by those who believe and know the truth. For everything created by God is good, and nothing is to be rejected, providing it is received with thanksgiving. For it is sanctified by God's word and by prayer. If you put these instructions before the brothers and sisters, you will be a good servant of Jesus Christ, nourished on the words of the faith and of sound teaching that you have followed, and nothing to do with profane myths and old wives' tales. Train yourself in godliness, for while physical training is of some value, godliness is valuable in every way, holding promise for both the present life and the life to come. This saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance. For to the end we toil and struggle, because we have our hope set on the living God, who is the Saviour of all people, especially those who believe. These are the things you must insist on and teach. Let no one despise your youth, but set the believers an example in speech and conduct, in love, in faith, in purity. Until I arrive, give attention to the public reading of Scripture, to exhorting the teaching. Do not neglect the gift that is in you, which was given to you through prophecy with the laying on of hands by the council of elders. Put these things into practice. Devote yourself to them, so that all may see your progress. Pay close attention to yourself and to your teaching. Continue in these things, for doing this you will save both yourself and your hearers. Well, Paul, writing to Timothy, who he has sent out to the churches, Paul, still residing in prison, and instructing Timothy on how to lead God's people. It hardly needs me to say anything, does it? Because it says it all there. And this Sunday, if you saw the Sunday service, still there online, so you can watch it again, we had Bible Sunday, and we heard stories from around the world where people were thankful for having a Bible brought to them by the Bible Society, or you know, other societies do the same, but the Bible Society is probably the best known for doing that. So it was people around the world who don't have a Bible because they're too poor to buy one, that they're just difficult to get hold of, places where there's persecution for Christians, so it is difficult to get one in your own language, and places where Bibles have been destroyed through war, conflict, where ISIS have been and have destroyed Bibles, as they do, obviously, burn or just destroy them, and it's dangerous in those areas to be found with a Bible, of course. So the work of the Bible Society around the world, a brilliant society, and one well worth donating to if you have got some spare cash. Just go to their website, press the button. But Bible Sunday was talking about the Bible. It is our Bible. It's our truth. It's our Haynes Manual, for those of you that remember Haynes Manuals. It's how we work. And Paul is saying it all here, and very much obviously written nearly 2,000 years ago, but so much use in today's world, because we hear so much around us about other religions, about false religions. There's so much out there that our young people, particularly, you know, when we're bringing up our children, are we telling them the truth? So, you know, don't renounce the faith by paying attention to deceitful spirits and teaching of demons through hypocrisy of liars. We might not put it that way, but let's not get bound up in worldly, earthly things, and forget our God, and forget to read our Bible that tells us how we should live. And it doesn't mean that we can't have things, that we can't have our nice homes, and we can't furnish them nicely, and we can't buy nice clothes. It's just being conscious about what we're doing and why we're doing it. And do we need those things? And could the money be better spent elsewhere? Just being very conscious about the blessings that we have in this country, because, you know, on the whole, we're so lucky. Although, obviously, this week we've heard an awful lot about free school meals and many children who are living in poverty. And we need to be aware of those things, because if we're not aware of them, we can't do anything about them. But when we get up to the pearly gates, is that ignorance worthy? Will St. Peter let us in because we chose to ignore what was around us, what was going on our own doorstep, let alone what goes on around the world, particularly with our Christian brothers and sisters around the world. So in everything, take it to God in prayer. Even, shall I buy that nice new dress in Hobbs, which is my favourite store? Why am I spending money on that? Is it because actually I do need some more clothes, or like my husband who's lost lots of weight, perhaps he should go and buy some new clothes. I might persuade him to do that. But just think about our actions, I think, is what we're saying. That we're not wrong in our actions, but we are wrong if we don't consider why we're doing things and what we're doing them for and those around us that might need our help. So let's pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks that you reveal yourself to us when we engage in the text of the Bible. Give us the desire and the discipline to study its teaching, to live what we learn, and to bring all things to you. Spirit of God, lead us into all truth. We give thanks for those who have translated the Bible into different languages. Bless the Bible Society in its work of making God's word understandable and available to all. We give thanks for those who help teach the Bible to young and old. Help them to show with clarity and enthusiasm the relevance of the Bible in today's life. And we give thanks for our fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, where we can talk and discuss what we've read in the Bible. May we bring fresh insights to each other and encouragement to all who are in Christ's family. Spirit of God, lead us into all truth. We give thanks for theologians and teachers and colleges, both here and overseas, those who inspire new leaders, who inspire congregations, who inspire new Christians. We think of all our Christian brothers and sisters around the world. We pray that they may each have their own Bible. We pray for all of those in places where they are persecuted for their faith, where they lose their lives for their faith. We pray particularly for our Christian brothers and sisters in Armenia and Nagorno-Karabakh under fire at this moment. We pray for all peoples who are suffering conflict, war, or natural disaster. All those places in the world that have been affected by climate change, where food is difficult to grow. And we pray and think of all those who are leaving homes, leaving home countries to try and seek a better life for their families. May they be welcomed with open arms. Spirit of God, lead us into all truth. And we give thanks for the health that we have. Pray for those facing serious illness, painful treatment, or failing health. We think of all of those on our prayer lists, those that we hold dear in our hearts and minds, and those around us that have no one to pray for them. Lord, may you bring them healing and comfort and hope. And we remember with thanksgiving those who have died, thinking of those whose funerals have taken place this week, for their families and friends. And we think of those whom we know, who we have loved and see no more. Learning from their example, we pray for strength to to follow him who is the incarnate Word, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and to serve in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so, bringing all our prayers together and lifting them to God, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Bless you, may you have a blessed week, and I will see you on Sunday or next week.